Thinkit's Nevis Information Service is pleased to present Current Speeches. In this edition of Current Speeches, we hear from the Honorable Patrice Nisbet in his capacity as Minister of Labour, and from the Right Honorable Dr. Denzel Douglas, Prime Minister of St. Kitts and Nevis. Their remarks were presented on 14 March 2013 at the launch of the National Workplace Policy on HIV and AIDS, Other Chronic Diseases, and Pilot Workplace Program. The speeches last about 30 minutes.
I want to say that I am very pleased to be here this morning for the launch of our workplace policy on HIV/AIDS, because as you know, this would mean something to me as a medical doctor by training. And in addition, I want to emphasize, as Ms. Posada said, that for several years now, I've had the honor of proposing and articulating on behalf of the Caribbean community the region's healthcare priorities and objectives. As you also may be aware, beginning some 30 years ago, there was a troubling and very indeed terrifying plague that began to make itself known in regions all around the world. And as the years moved on, a number of people being afflicted by this illness consistently grew, and the regions also affected steadily spread. And then incredibly, those of us who inhabit this part of the universe began to hear that this region, our own very Caribbean region, being mentioned with some increase in frequency as being among the most highly infected regions on Earth. That, I must say, was the situation then, but it is not the situation as we would say now. And the reasons for the difference between then and now are very, very many. The changes have come thanks to the advances, firstly, in medical science, and they have come thanks also to our own country's collaboration with a number of initiatives around the world, one, of course, being the Clinton Global Initiative. They have come thanks to what I consider to be a very continuing public education campaign that we have maintained here in our own federation. And they have come thanks to the insights, the vigilance, and the dedication of healthcare workers in our own hospitals and the healthcare centers all across this country. And because of all of these realities, HIV/AIDS are no longer the merciless death sentences that they once were. And that is why today I'm very pleased that we are where we are. And this is taking place really under the guidance of our new Minister of Labour, the Honourable Patrice Nisbet. Give him a round of applause. The fact that the HIV and AIDS are no longer a death sentence, however, does not absolve our people of the need to be sexually responsible. It does not absolve us of the responsibility, to recognize and remember that HIV/AIDS, like diabetes, like cancer, or any other major illness, is a serious condition. And so we should and must do all that is in our power, first to avoid contracting HIV and AIDS, just as we should do all in our power to avoid lifestyles that could lead to cancer or diabetes or hypertension. And if we are fortunate enough to avoid these illnesses, we should keep it that way. And so what we are seeking to do here in terms of highlighting HIV/AIDS at the workplace, so too I believe the time is right for us to recognize the importance of being very much aware of the sensitivities with regard to what can happen at the workplace with regard to cancer, diabetes or hypertension. And I'm sure that the ministry will do all that it can to also give us the necessary support at the workplace for these chronic non-communicable diseases. The reality is, however, that in this country, as in countries all across the globe, cancer is a reality. Hypertension, it is a reality. And diabetes is a reality. And I emphasize, HIV/AIDS is a reality. It is here. It's not going to go anywhere. It's here. And so we must make sure that we understand in the workplace that it is a reality. And so it is important that those critics and divisions who are grappling with the consequences of any of these illnesses are able to make their livings in workplaces that meet internationally established standards in terms of inclusion and in terms of receptivity. Standards to which we have committed ourselves as parties to the ILO promoted decent work agenda. The OECS Decent Work Country Program, as we know, it advocates the reviewing and the updating of labor legislation. This we consistently do. It also encourages improved information flows regarding the labor market, and this too has long been a national priority. It promotes inclusive, non-discriminatory workplace policies where chronic disease patients are concerned. And the memorandum of understanding that we will sign today, as I see on your leaflet there, as well as so much that we have advocated and done before today, be a witness to our commitment in that regard. And it stresses the importance of communication. Communication between governments and government workers, both within individual OECS countries and throughout the OECS in general. Again, something to which I can attest in light of my leadership role within the region on health. Because of everything that I have stated thus far, it will be no surprise to anyone, I am sure, when I say that the launch of this workplace policy program is important for our country and is both as Prime Minister and as a concerned member of society that it definitely, and I stress again, is important to me. The International Labour Organization, with which our government has worked for so many years and on so many occasions, and with which our country has had such a long and very positive history, is once again a part of yet another St. Kitts-based project, the effort on which we are focusing today. And we warmly welcome, therefore, the ILO's Office for the Caribbean and the Decent Work team as the partner with us in the launch and in the implementation of this very important pilot process. And I should also mention that I am especially pleased by the tripartite nature of our undertaking this morning, and by the broad support that this effort has attracted, as evidenced by the presence here this morning of not only the Office of the Prime Minister and high officials of the Ministry of Health, represented, I would think, by the Permanent Secretary, since I don't see the Minister, but by both the labor and the business communities, in the persons of the Minister of Labor himself, the Honorable Patrice Nisbet, and our Labor Commissioner, Mr. Spencer Amory, also represented by the St. Kitts and Nevis Trades and Labor Union, who, as you've heard a moment ago, is represented by Batumba Tak, the General Secretary himself, and also the St. Kitts Chamber of Industry and Commerce, represented by the President himself, Mr. Lake, and of course, the Executive Director, Mr. Cable, who addressed us a moment ago. And so, in closing, I wish also to make a point of thanking Mrs. Maturi Supersad. The HIV-AIDS specialist at the International Labour Organization, and also our own Dr. Joy, or Kathleen, I know as Ferdinand, the National Specialist Consultant, and Ms. Shermel James, the HIV focal point within our own Department of Labour, for their role in this morning's proceedings. And I once again stress my own support for this effort, the support of my entire cabinet of colleagues, which will bolster so significantly the efforts of all of us who for so long have been striving to ensure that here in our own St. Kitts and Nevis, our workplaces are free of the feelings, and I stress that, free of the feelings of exclusion. Because, and not only exclusion, but isolation as well, which are not only indefensible from a medical or scientific point of view, but which as a matter of human and indeed moral concerns are just simply wrong. People with HIV/AIDS or people associated with HIV/AIDS must be allowed to work, must be allowed to exist. And those of you who are those of us, I should say, who do not want to embrace them, it's because we are ignorant and really should take ignorance out of this in an enlightened society like St. Kitts and Nevis. So to positive, constructive, and inclusive workplaces for all, I say, across the length and breadth of this land, is what we want to achieve. Thank you.
It is for me a single honor and privilege to have been afforded the opportunity to bring brief remarks at this most auspicious of events. The launch of a national workplace policy on HIV/AIDS and other chronic diseases, and the implementation of a pilot workplace program. For over a generation, some 30 years plus, the global community has been beleaguered by the HIV/AIDS epidemic, which have wrought socio-economic hardship on those afflicted with the disease, stressed to breaking point health and social care delivery systems, spawned the twins' stigma and discrimination that for so long informed the prejudices which have impeded advocacy and preventative strategies designed to halt and reverse the spread of HIV and AIDS. Unfortunately, the challenges spawned by the HIV and AIDS epidemic are now being exacerbated by the alarming rise in other chronic non-communicable diseases such as diabetes, hypertension, cancers, asthma, and alcoholism, all of which are contributing to the rise in absenteeism from work, sickness, hospitalization, and are now the leading causes of death in the Federation. The impact on the workplace and on the national productivity, with all its attendant direct and indirect socio-economic consequences, pose a threat to the wealth generation capacity of St. Kitts and Nevis. Indeed, ladies and gentlemen, the stark reality is that HIV/AIDS and other non-communicable diseases has become a major developmental issue. The social economic indicators on the matter speak for themselves. And in our Caribbean region, we are anchored to the rather ignoble status of being second in magnitude to sub-Sahara in the incidences of the epidemic. The reality has spawned international, regional, and local agencies and government to face the HIV/AIDS issues head on. And thus we see collaborative efforts which arches many governmental and non-governmental agencies being undertaken to address the issue, which is a human issue with all of its complexities. The government of St. Kitts and Nevis, through the lead agency on HIV/AIDS, the Ministry of Labor, Department of Labor, Ministry of Health, has ensured that the implementation strategies to mitigate HIV/AIDS, non-communicable diseases, were encapsulated in a priority policy imperative. Indeed, the social partners, tripartite constituents, made up of government, workers' organization, and employers' organization, identified the promoting inclusive workplace policy on HIV/AIDS as one of the four priorities area for the Federation's Decent Work Country Program. Under the ILO Decent Work Concept and Agenda, promulgated by the ILO and its Decent Work Country Team and Office for the Caribbean, the four priority areas are reviewing and updating the Federation's labor legislation, strengthening the labor market information system, encouraging dialogue between government, employers, and workers on national, regional, social, and economic issues. The ILO and the ILO Decent Work Country Team and the Office for the Caribbean are to be commended and publicly lauded for the invaluable support, technical and financial, which has been rendered to the Federation to bring about the realization of the Decent Work Country Program, and in particular, this significant priority item. And I wish to avail myself of this opportunity at this point in time to ask Ms. Supersad to convey to the ILO the heartfelt sentiments of the government of St. Kitts and Nevis, and to reiterate our support and commitment to the ideals and principles promoted by the ILO. The launch of the National Workplace Policy on HIV/AIDS and other chronic diseases, and the implementation of a pilot workplace program in both the public and private sectors underscores government commitment to developing practical policy responses in the interests of our true wealth of our human resources. The policy was guided by, one, the National Health Policy, the Convention on the Elimination of All Forms of Discrimination Against Women, the National HIV and AIDS Strategy Framework, the ILO Code of Practice on HIV/AIDS and the World of Work, and the ILO Recommendation Number 200 concerning HIV and AIDS and the World of Work. Through the pilot workplace program, it is envisioned that workplaces would put in train mechanisms and processes to, one, promote the development of a supportive, ethical, and human rights-based work environment that protects the fundamental rights of workers living with HIV/AIDS and other chronic diseases. Two, provide guidelines for the workplace to effectively manage of people living with HIV and AIDS and other chronic diseases. Three, ensure a consistent approach in dealing with all workers living with HIV and AIDS and other chronic diseases. It is indeed heartening to see that the private sector, so well represented here, and as participants in the pilot implementation program. It signals, ladies and gentlemen, that another milestone has been achieved in the collaborative efforts to address the HIV/AIDS and other chronic diseases issue. That multipartite ownership of the policy initiative is indeed a reality this morning. As we continue this journey together, let us be mindful of our human resources. Of our human resources, rights to a healthy and safe working environment, to dignity in and out of the workplace, to be stigma and discrimination free, to support and assistance and freedom from victimization because of their health status, to be educated on the threat of HIV/AIDS and other non-communicable diseases, and to the benefit of embracing healthy lifestyles. Let us be mindful of our shared responsibility to promote and live indeed and word the ideals and principles enshrined in the National Workplace Policy on HIV/AIDS and other other chronic diseases. In closing, Permit me to thank all those who have toiled to achieve the milestone and to thank all public and private sector enterprises who have consented to be a part of the pilot implementation process. You have lit the light and illuminated the path forward in our responses to the challenges of HIV and AIDS and other chronic diseases, and I am confident that others will follow where you lead.